So 11th class, we are to start with the programs of for loop first. Okay. There is no hard and fast rule that this program has to be done by for only, not while only. Okay. It is up to you. If your logic is correct, definitely we will correct the program. It is not any hard and fast rule that what logic I have given, you have to apply that logic only. If you have some other logic, that will be accepted as it will increase your programming skills. Okay. So I am starting with the first program, factorial of a number. Okay. Offline class. Online class. Am I clear up till here? All right. So what is the concept behind factorial of a number? Mathematically, if I am to denote factorial, I'll be writing 5 ! 5 factorial. Mathematically, we represent it like this. What is factorial? A number multiplied by preceding number up till 1. All the preceding numbers up till 1. Why not 0? It will become entire 0. When you multiply anything by 0, it becomes complete 0. It may go in decrement way. It may come in increment way. Right now, what figure I have typed in front of you, it is going backward. Decrement 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I may go in increment way. Okay, it is up to you. You want to run the loop in increment or decrement. Clear? Now, a number whose factorial you want to find, first of all, type that, input that number. Enter the number. Since my number must be a whole number, number without fractions, right? Number without fractions. So I have taken the number of type integer. I have taken the number of type integer. Okay. Am I clear?
Recording is going on.
Next. Now, suppose I am to find the factorial of 6. If I am to find factorial of 6, I'll be multiplying 6 with all the preceding numbers. But on the initial stage, for the very first stage, my number 1 will be multiplied with a fixed value so that the series starts. Ekdam to 2 aani jayega. शुरुआत तो 1 से होगी. 1 अपने आप से किसी के साथ मल्टीप्लाई होगा ताकि वो सीरीज में आ जाए. सो दैट द सीरीज ऑफ प्रोडक्ट स्टार्ट्स. बिकॉज इन द इनिशियल स्टेज 1 कैन नॉट बी मल्टीप्लाई बाय 2. 2 विल कम व्हेन आई विल इंक्रीमेंट इन द नेक्स्ट स्टेज. आई एम इन द फर्स्ट स्टेज. So in the first stage, 1 will be multiplied by 1. 1 will be multiplied by 1. 1 ones are 1. Then 1 twos are 2. 2 threes are 6. Like this. So for that, what I'll be doing, I am taking a variable f whose initial value I set to 1. You can take any variable A, B, C, D, E, not any hard and fast rule. Now, for loop starts, I in range. Range means the starting and the ending. Now put your pen down, offline class, and pay attention on the LCD and understand this concept. बेटे इफ आई से 1, n इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 1 इट विल गो टिल n माइनस 1 इन द लास्ट लेक्चर आई मेक दिस पॉइंट क्लियर टू यू दैट रेंज फंक्शन ऑफ फॉर लूप टेक्स द लोअर लिमिट बट इट डज नॉट टेक द हायर लिमिट हायर लिमिट माइनस 1 यानी इफ आई एम टू फाइंड द फैक्टोरियल ऑफ 6 इट विल गो टिल 5 एंड आंसर विल नॉट बी फ्रूटफुल यू डिडंट गेट माय पॉइंट आई रिपीट इफ आई एम टू फाइंड फैक्टोरियल ऑफ 6 इट शुड बी 1, 2, 6 बट इफ आई एम गोइंग विद 1, n लूप इट विल गो टिल 5 n is 6 n minus 1 5 I won't be getting the desired result so when I am going one stage ahead then I am one stage back agar mujhe 10 tak jana hai to mujhe 11 tak jana padega agar mujhe 6 tak jana hai to mere ko 7 tak jana padega so I'll be going 1 n plus 1 If n is 6, n plus 1 is 7, automatically it will go till 6. Got it? Of online class, is the concept clear? Why I have taken n plus 1? Beta, I have to go till 6. If I'll be taking n plus 1, it will go till 7. So automatically n minus 1, it will run the loop till 6. Okay. Applying the colon here and starting the block of the for loop. Wherever you put the colon, from there the block starts. And automatically you will see statements will be indented. Where you put the colon and press the enter key, the statements will be automatically indented. Indented means little away from the margin. Now see where the cursor is blinking. See where the cursor is blinking. Okay. It is automatically indented. Right. Am I audible online class? Prabdeep, Diya, Ramanjeet. Am I audible to all? All right. So. F. Equal to. F. Into I. Now, let me show the working of this. What is initial value of F? 1. I have initialized here, na? What is first value of I? 1. Let me type here again. What is F into I? One into one. So what is final F? One. Whatever is the result of F into I, the result is assigned to the variable F again. Every time variable F is updated with the new value that you will obtain by multiplying the value of F with the current value of I. So in this stage, F is 1. Okay. Now, I gets increment. I becomes 2. What is the last value of updated F? 1. What is I? 2. What is F into I? 1 into 2. What is final F? 2. The updated F in this stage is 2. Moving to the third stage, what is updated F for the third stage? 2. What is I? 3. What is 2 into 3? 6. So updated F for this iteration is 6. Iteration means this step, current step. F is 6 for the next stage. What is I? Very good. 4. What is 6 into 4? Updated F is 24. For the next stage, F is 24. What is I? 5. 24 into 5. F is 120. Still the loop is true. Abhi bhi for loop true hai. Kyunki for loop 6 tak chalna hai. F is 120 for the next stage. What is I? 6. 120 into 6. 720. F is 720 for the next iteration. But when I become 7, for loop fails. Because higher limit is not included. Agar 7 diya hai, wo 6 tak chalega. Par jab I 7 ho gaya, for loop will fail. Am I clear, online class? This is N, we are inputting here. We have input N in the initial stage only. So what will be the final F? This F. The final value of F will get print. Am I clear with the factorial? So this equation will keep on solving automatically till the loop becomes fail. Now I came out of the loop. See where the cursor is blinking. Cursor is blinking again on the left margin. I have come out of the body of the loop. Now this statement is a normal statement. It is not the part of for loop. Print factorial equal to F. Okay. Am I clear, online class? So I save this program. Fact plus one program. Enter the number 6. Factorial is 720. Am I clear to all with the logic of the code? Yes, class. Am I clear with the logic? All right. Now, moving to the next concept. Fibonacci series. We are to start Fibonacci series. Now, what is Fibonacci series? Fibonacci series is a series in which every third term is the sum of first two terms. Initially, we input 0 and 1. Third term is 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 1, 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 5, 13. 13 plus 8, 21. 21 plus 13, 34. Like this, the series continues. This is Fibonacci series. Now, Fibonacci series is in two options. Either you run up till fixed size. Ki maine ye size dena hai aur meri Fibonacci series is size tak chale. To aap direct value input kar do 6 or 8 or 10 or 9 whatever. Up till that value the Fibonacci will run. Second is you input the size. At run time you input the size that up till this size my series should run. So I am inputting the size. Enter the limit. Up to which limit you want to generate your Fibonacci series. Okay. From at the initial stage, I am taking two values from my side. A is 0 B is 1. And print these two values. Print these two values. So 0, 1 to print ho gaye. First term, second term, dono print ho gaye. First term and second term both get print. What is my first term? 0. What is my second term? 1. Suppose in your chemistry book, chapter 1 is not chapter 1. It is chapter 0. And you have 16 chapters in your book. What will be the index of last chapter? 15. If your first chapter is having number 0, the 16th chapter will be having number 15. Okay. Am I clear? Similarly, in Fibonacci series, my first term is having index 0. My second term is having index 1. My third term will be represented by 2. Jo third term main add karke nikalunga, uska index 2 hoga. Index beshak 2 hai, lekin wo third term hai. Represented by number 2. 2 means 3. 3 means 4. 4 means 5. So, pehli do terms to main print karwai chuka hun. I have a question. From which term my loop will start? First two terms I have already print. From which term my loop will start? Third. Third means 2. Third means 2. For x in range 2, n. N means n minus 1 automatically. N ka matlab n minus 1. Agar main limit 10 dunga, to ye kahan tak chalega? 9 tak. Apne aap 10 ho gaya, kyunki pehla index 0 hai. Okay. Now see the blackboard, LCD, all of you. Every third term is a sum of previous two terms. Every third term is the sum of previous two terms. Third term ko print karwa dijiye. Now see. First term 0. Second term 1. What is the third term? 0 plus 1, 1. Ye meri first term thi. Ye meri second term thi. Ye meri third term aagayi. Ab agar mujhe series ko aage generate karwana hai. If I want to generate the series further, I have to interchange their positions. Now third will become second. And second will become first. Third will become second. Second will become first. Now 1 plus 1, 2. Then again swapping will take place. So how this swapping to be done? Second term has given its value to first term. B variable has given its value to A variable. B goes empty. B will occupy the position of C. C is at the right. B is at the left. Assignment goes from right to left. Ye C hai. Ye B hai. Assignment C se B mein hogi. Kabhi bhi B se C mein nahi jayegi. Okay, am I clear? See my hands. This is B. This is C. Assignment goes from C to B. It never come from B to C. This is right side. This is left. Okay. Am I clear? So this will keep on executing till the end of for loop. Enter the limit 10. Check out. Check it out. Online class. Am I clear with the program of Fibonacci series? Prabdeep Kaur, Ramanjeet. Give your response, both of you. Ramanjeet Singh, no response is coming. Aryaman, Himanshu, Arshdeep, Chirag, Tarun. Is the concept clear? Fibonacci series. Manjot, Diksha, Arshpreet. Yes, offline class. Any doubt? Zero to nine, 10 ho gaya na. Clear? Is Fibonacci clear, all of you? All right. You can see the code. I'm giving you 1 minute. Go through the coding carefully. So my next question is to find the sum of even and odd numbers from 1 to 100. Even number we know, number dividing by 2 and giving the remainder 0. And odd number is when number divide by 2 and remainder is 1. Okay. To find the sum of even number, I am taking variable S1, initializing with 0. Just as in factorial you studied, the first value has to be multiplied with one particular constant. 1 into 1. 1. Similarly, while calculating the sum, the first value 1 will be added with some digit, that is 0. 0 plus 1, 1. S1 represents the sum of all even numbers. S2 represents sum of all odd numbers. We are to find sum up till 100. So 1 to 101. It will go till 100. It will go till 100. How we will check even number? What is X representing? X is representing all numbers from 1 to 101. First value of X is 1. If I modulus value of X with 2 and remainder comes out to 0. Check this condition. X ko 2 ke saath modulus karo. Agar remainder 0 ke equate ho jaye, that means number is even. Okay. Because X is representing all numbers from 1 to 100. If this condition goes true, then find the sum of odd even numbers. S1 equal to S1 plus X. What is S1 initially? 0 plus jo bhi X hoga. Then S1 will get updated. S1 will get updated every time when this condition will get true. Okay. going to the else part. Do I have, is there need to check condition for else? Automatically, if number is not even in the first condition, it is odd. So we will find sum of odd numbers. ये देखो ना, अगर ये कंडीशन फेल हो जाती है कि वो नंबर जीरो रिमाइंडर नहीं देता, तो बट ऑब्वियस है वो एल्स पे जाएगा. एल्स पे हम ऑड नंबर्स का सम करेंगे. जैसे वन है, वन मॉडुलस टू नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो, हम इधर आ गए. एस टू क्या है? जीरो प्लस वन. एस टू क्या अपडेट हो गया? वन. मान लो आगे थ्री आ गया, थ्री मॉडुलस टू नहीं होता, अगेन एल्स पे गया. एस टू क्या था पहले? फर्स्ट स्टेज में एस टू क्या हो गया था? वन. वन प्लस थ्री फोर. इस तरह से समझ गए. अब लूप के बाहर आके सम ऑफ इवन नंबर्स एस वन प्रिंट करा दो, सम ऑफ odd numbers print S2. Am I clear? And save this program. Even odd plus one two. Right? Enter the limit. See, all the even numbers in the range 1 to 100 will have total value 2550. Add karke 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 12 plus 14 plus 16 like this. And all the odd numbers 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 likewise so on, the sum is 2500. Am I clear, online class? Yes, online class, any doubt? All right.